Good morning, Calvary. My name is Robert. Grateful to have you guys tuning in for your word for the day today. Have you ever wondered how we can know that Jesus is real? Like really real? Maybe that's a question you've wrestled with, or maybe you've had people come to you and ask, hey, how do we know? Or maybe more generally, how do you know that God is real and that Jesus was in fact more than just a human teacher? The format and time restraint of this video doesn't allow me to get into a full-length explanation of this. You have your day to go and do instead of watching this video all day long. But if you really want to dive into this, I'd suggest a book titled The Problem of God by Mark Clark as a way to really dig into this further. But I do want to share from today's section from the book of Mark one way that Jesus showed us his divinity. In Mark chapter 14, starting in verse 27, it says this. And Jesus said to them, "You will all fall away, for it is written, 'I will strike the shepherd, and the sheep will be scattered.' But after I am raised up, I will go before you to Galilee." And Peter said to him, "Even though they all fall away, I will not." And Jesus said to him, "Truly I tell you, this very night, before the rooster crows twice, you will deny me three times." But Peter said emphatically, "If I must die with you, I will not deny you." And they all said the same. So here at the conclusion of the Last Supper, as Jesus is just mere hours away from his death, he makes a prediction on how his disciples will respond to this moment. And he actually makes two. He quotes a passage from Zechariah chapter 13 on how they will all scatter at Jesus' persecution and death. And then he specifically states that Peter will deny him. But he makes it even more specific. It says he will deny him three times, and to even make it more specific, that it will happen before the rooster crows a second time the next morning. Now, as you may know, or maybe not, but both of these were fulfilled exactly. The disciples scattered and hid in response to Jesus' death, but before that happened, Peter denied knowing Jesus and being one of his disciples three times, the third event happening just before a rooster crowed the second time. When Peter realized this, he was crushed with the weight and guilt of what he was done. But it wasn't just this prediction. When you read through the Old Testament and look at it in light of Jesus' death and resurrection and his life as well, there's literally hundreds of prophecies that range from 500 to 1500 years before the birth and eventual death of Jesus, ranging from things like what family he would come from, to the town he would be born in, to what he would be called, to how he would teach, and how he would be falsely accused and punished, and even several specific details of how he would be killed and buried. Now, being able to predict one or two of these things would be just amazing and mind-blowing. In fact, the probability of accurately predicting the amount that Jesus would be betrayed for in the money was once calculated as 1 in 100 billion in terms of the odds. That's just one fact. And there's hundreds of accurate and direct prophecies of Jesus in the Old Testament. So as we look at this, know that Jesus' life wasn't a fluke. It wasn't random. He wasn't just a guy who decided to go and try to be someone, and he went viral in the news for being just that charismatic and awesome. And when you think about the prediction of Peter, remember the grace that Peter experienced afterwards, but also remember the evidence that this gives us for the fact that Jesus was in fact God. And let that help you worship and follow him with greater confidence and greater truth today. Hope this is a help for you today. We'll see you next time, Calvary.